here with the cast of Republic of Doyle. Can you guys tell me about the family atmosphere you've had on set and off set as well?
The on-set family atmosphere obviously is the core really of the entire series in so many ways. They're a group of people who have conflict, obviously. They have lots of flaws, but they band together. And it's funny, in a parallel universe, our cast, there's no flaws, I'm excluding myself from it, and there's almost no conflict. I have not seen one. It's just like the most, everything that you want Sean McGinley to be, I can vouch and say that he's better and more. Everything you want Kristen Pellerin to be, she's the sweetest, most genuine person, and the same goes for our entire cast, for Martha, Mark, for Linda, for Sean Panting. It's just such a warm, generous group of people. It was a privilege to have the chance to be around them for 6 seasons.
So there's no conflict, so it's really not like a real family at all, or not like my family anyway.
Well, this is a genetically engineered family. It wasn't organic in the sense that it was handpicked. So maybe the conflict was preempted. We got the you know, I don't know, as I said a few times now, I think it comes from the top down. When you have people like Alan and Rob and John that run an organization like Take the Shot and a big scale production like Republic of Doyle, the care they've taken in hiring various people and pairing people up and stuff like that, and the fact that people, you know, without exception, I can't think of one person on this show that wasn't happy to come into work every morning. You know, like everybody was. So it was a genuine sense of community and communal energy and working towards something collectively. All the things that we aspire to but rarely achieve, you know. So we were privileged, really.
Yeah, and we all got the chance to grow into this together and grow up together. So we all sort of went through the 6 years together, and you just can't have that connection from then on. So it's great.
And if there's anything you want to say to the fans who've been with you so many years, what would that be?
I've been going on about this. Do you want me to take that?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. I've been saying this for some time, that when you make a piece of work in this industry, whether it's theater or art or television, film, it's very rare to get a large group of people who endorse it and get behind you. And I know for myself in this business, I've been working for a long time trying to get people to pay attention to the work you're doing. So when people get behind it, like the people who support Republic of Doyle, the people who are here tonight, those of you that have reported on us and are helping us tell our story, I have immense gratitude. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Just that I think, you know, that the fans for this show have been so supportive and so loyal. And we've had a huge audience from the very beginning. And I think in the last season, I think the writers and the actors and the directors have really honored their side of the bargain, really. So hopefully the fans are going to like it. So,
just to say thank you, thank you, thank you to the fans, because they are so hardcore and so devoted, and you just feel the love coming from them all the time, and we're really lucky. Like, they're right there with us, and it's an awesome feeling.
Well, thank you so much. Congratulations, and have a wonderful time this evening.
Thank you, Katie. Thanks so much.
Thank you. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. Thank you.